the important few points which should be remembered for the brews, they are, first the word brews and petitions, they are mostly used synonymously, but they have a little different meaning. And then about the shape, size, and the appearance of brews. The brews is the word used synonymously, bruise and contagion. Bruising is when it is visible through the skin. That means skin is bruised. It is visible through the skin. Whereas the contusion, when it is not visible through the skin, and it is usually to the heart viscera, internal viscera. So skin is bruised and the viscera are contused. Both having the same meaning. The surface are intact and there is the bleeding under the surfaces, that which is visible through the skin is called bruise, and in the viscera like kidney, liver and intestine it is contusion or contused. So the contusion and bruises synonymously used have a different meaning. Contusion is for the skin and bruise is for the skin and contusion for the contents of the viscera. So skin is bruised and the liver is contused. This is a plane showing the contusion. Now regarding the shape of the bruise, it, usually the object, it will be like the object, how broad, how what is the size of the object. But you cannot comment upon, because the size can be any, but the force, amount of force applied can be having wider effects. So you cannot comment upon the, by looking at the weapon, that this weapon was used, that how much will be the size of the bruise. Because it is due to extravasation of the blood and this is due to rupture of the capillaries, and the shape is variable because it may not correspond to the size of the weapon and shape of the weapon. Hence, no definite shape. And similarly, the size, no definite size and no definite shape. And it can be from pinpoint or pinhead size to a frayed hematoma. And when it is pinhead size, it is called as petechial hemorrhage. Usually in asphyxia, fine pinpoint hemorrhages due to pressure, when there is compression, interference with the respiration, or at any level, at the chest, at the neck, there is pooling of the blood because of the pressure, and the rupture of fine blood vessel will be producing petechiae. So fine pinpoint size hemorrhage will be petechiae. Their collection, they, when collected together, it is called ecchymosis. And a frame blood collection is called hematoma. So it can be, the size can be from pinhead size to frame hematoma. Now the appearance of the bruise, how it appears freshly, you will not elicit any color change. Only the swelling, a painful swelling will be seen. No color change, no variegated appearance, no change in the color will be visible. Only there will be painful swelling initially. And sometimes it is ectopic, away from the site of infliction. And sometimes it is delayed. So that they have to be distinct, because the site of application is away, and the collection of blood is far distant from the site of application. So you must be vigilant enough to examine the areas which can show the ectopic and which can show the delayed bruising. The ectopic bruising is that the extravasated blood travels because of the effect of the gravity. For example, the impact is on the top of the head. The blood will flow down beneath the scalp and will be collected around the eyes, showing a black eye phenomenon. this flowing down is because of the effect of the gravity, and this is known as ectopic bruising. Because from the site of infliction of the force, blood oozes out, but it flows down because of the effect of the gravity, and it appears at the distant site than the application of force area. That's why it is called as ectopic bruising. And the typical example, blunt trauma on the forehead or the top of the head causing the black eye. So this is the area of impact. The blood flowing down and collecting around the eye, and it will be visible as a black eye phenomenon. Then the delayed bruising. Sometimes the extravasation of the blood is in the deeper tissues, and it takes time to become visible through the skin. And usually they are the cases of cholestasis.